and in the path of the tsunami as it moved west, Hawaii and the U.S. coast. Parts of California remain under a state of emergency in Crescent City, California. The Coast Guard now calling off a search for a man swept out to sea and feared dead in marinas and ports. There's millions of dollars in damage. Here's video of the tsunami wave tearing through a harbor in Santa Cruz. That wave, as you can see, just moving the boats like they were toys as it rips through the dock and the pier. Joining us now live in Los Angeles is Casey Stegall with more details. Casey, that video is incredible to watch.
Yeah, Kelly, it really gives you chills, and no doubt the western part of the United States is certainly not immune to this disaster. We are talking about significant damage to at least two California coastal communities. One is way up north near the Oregon border. The other is of the video you just saw. That is south of the San Francisco Bay Area in Santa Cruz, California. In fact, about 70 miles south of San Fran. We cannot show this video enough. Dramatic pictures of waves crashing into the harbor there. The rolling surge causing boats to collide and docks to crumble. In all, emergency officials tell us about 100 vessels were damaged, 20 sunk. There were fortunately no reports of injuries. However, the damage expected to be more than $2 million, and eyewitnesses telling us they have never seen anything like this before.
Boats sinking, boats crunching underneath the bridge that separates the upper and lower harbor. And then I've been on my boat and almost had a sunken boat wedge up underneath my boat.
Also, check this out. About 430 miles up the coast from that location in Crescent City, California, a bystander capturing amateur video of the heavy surf coming in where an 8-foot wave was experienced there. It did damage to roughly 35 boats and also sweeping one person out to sea. Search and rescue crews believe the victim was trying to take a picture of the tsunami with some friends. His body has not yet been recovered. He is feared dead. Finally, we are also getting reports about extensive damage and flooding in parts of Hawaii as well. Early tsunami warnings got a lot of the people evacuated. Reports of tourists evacuated from beachfront resorts and hotels, but the governor there has declared a disaster. An awful lot of damage done out west as well, Kelly.